الحمد لله إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا أحمده تعالى حمدا لا يحد وأشكره شكرا لا يعد وأصلي وأسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله ومن اقتفى أثره إلى يوم المعاد إخوة الإيمان أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله تعالى فقد فاز المتقون يقول الله تبارك وتعالى فيما روى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وهو حديث قدسي قال عبد الرحمن بن صخر الدوسي رضي الله عنه اللي هو أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فيما يرويه عن ربه يقول الله عز وجل أنا عند ظن عبدي بي وفي رواية فليظن بي ما شاء فإن ذكرني في نفسه ذكرته في نفسي فإن ذكرني في نفسه ذكرته في نفسي فإن ذكرني في نفسه ذكرته في نفسي وإن ذكرني في ملأ ذكرته في ملأ خير منهم وإن أتاني أو إن تقرب إلي بشبر تقربت إليه ذراعا وإن تقرب إلي بذراع تقربت إليه باعا وإن أتاني يمشي أتيته هرولة. Today inshallah ta'ala I would like to remind us of something that is so important in our lives. It is an aspect of at-tawheed that scholars say some people are oblivious of this aspect of at-tawheed, so much so that some of the scholars like Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab has put a topic on this subject, Husnu dhan billah. What is your opinion? How do you think of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And in the hadith that I have just mentioned, this hadith, Hadith al-Qudsi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, Ana inda dhanni abdi bi. I am how my servant thinks of me. I am how my servant thinks of me. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this Hadith al-Qudsi, He says, then think of me whatever you wish. Think of me whatever you want. And then instead of talking about other things, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls our attention to something else. He says, فَإِن ذَكَرَنِي فِي نَفْسِهِ. If my servant thinks of me or remembers me in his own self, ذَكَرْتُهُ فِي نَفْسِهِ, I will also remember him to my own self. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if he remembers me in a group of people or in such a group, then I will remember him in a better group. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, wa in taqarraba ilayya, if my servant draws closer to me, the measure of a span, bishibrin, then I will draw closer to him, dhira'an, this measure. Meaning that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you think of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala turns to you twice, or threefold, or manyfold. And, وَإِن تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ بِذِرَاعٍ تَقَرَّبْتُ إِلَيْهِ بَاعًا. If he comes closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, bidhira', this measure, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will draw closer to him a fathom. Wa in atani yamshi. And if he comes close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or he goes closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yamshi, walking, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will go towards him running. Why is this important? This aspect of tawheed is important because when you think of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you have good thoughts about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, these thoughts, they are going to breed in your life al-amalu salih. You're going to, insha'Allah ta'ala, do what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prescribed. Do what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has taught. And you're going to keep away from anything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prohibited, anything that is displeasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Al-Imam Muslim rahimahullah ta'ala, he narrates hadith by Jabir radiyallahu anhu. He says, Sami'tu Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qabla wafatihi bi thalath ayyam. I heard the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam 3 days before his death. What did I hear? To show something that is so important, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, just before he dies, he reminds us, he instructs us, he says, La yamutanna ahadukum illa wa huwa hasanu dhan billahi azza wa jal. None of you should die except that he has good thoughts. He thinks well of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is important in our lives because when you think of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you have positive thoughts of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you are positive, you believe, as Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala says, وَلَا رَيْبَ أَنَّ حُسْنَ الظَّنِّ بِاللَّهِ إِنَّمَا يَكُونُ مَعَ حُسْنِ الْعَمَلِ. There is no doubt that having good thoughts of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes or goes hand in hand with what? Husnul amal. That you're going to do things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded. You believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded you to do things, these things, righteous deeds, and therefore you expect rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Otherwise, contrary to this belief, الَّذِي ذَمَّ اللَّهُ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has talked ill of people who have ill thoughts of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is an aspect of disbelievers, munafiqeen wal mushrikeen wal kuffar, وَيُعَذِّبَ الْمُنَافِقِينَ وَالْمُنَافِقَاتِ وَالْمُشْرِكِينَ وَالْمُشْرِكَاتِ أَظَّنِّينَ بِاللَّهِ ظَنَّ السَّوْءِ عَلَيْهِمْ دَائِرَةُ السَّوْءِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and he's going to punish the hypocrites, male and female, and the polytheists, male and female. Why? أَظَّنِّينَ بِاللَّهِ, those who have ill thoughts of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If today as believers, what would make us have good thoughts of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The first thing and the primary thing is that we already know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through Asma'illahi al-Husna. We know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through His names, the beautiful names, the beautiful attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if you know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as in another hadith al-Qudsi, when He created al-Jannah wal-Nar, He sent the angels. And when they looked at al-Jannah and wa-huffatil jannah, and you know, Jannah, you know, it has everything that is displeasing to the self. You know, things that are difficult, hardships. And when the angels came back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, said that we don't think anybody is going to enter Jannah. Why? Because huffat bil makari, and the opposite of an-nar, an-nar huffat bi ash-shahawat wal maladhat, you know, it is beautified with things that, you know, are good, and we covet them, we desire them. that nobody, the angels feared that nobody is going to keep away from hellfire except that they are going to fall into hellfire. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. So when you think of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you know that He has created human beings with this disposition that either they are going to do righteous deeds or they are going to be rebellious to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but you remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has guided us, He has put al-fitra in ourselves. You believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has guided me. He has given me the inclination. He has given me the ability to do what is right. Then it motivates you to do the bidding of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he says, Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala says that when you have good thoughts of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you are going to do righteous deeds because you believe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to reward you for the good deeds. You also believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept your forgiveness. You also believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-adl. So this is why this is important in our lives. And we are also reminding ourselves of husnul dhann billah, because today anything that we do, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam kana yu'jibuhu, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to love optimism, that when you believe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you hope Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to accept your amal. You fear that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take you to an-nar because of what you have done, then again it motivates you. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah As-Safat, you know, He talks of, you know, many things that when, you know, He created the angels and, you know, the attributes of these angels and all that. And then He talks about different messengers. Then He says, and part or among the messengers that He has sent is Ibrahim alayhi wa ala nabiyyina afdalu salati wa taslim. When He came to His people and He saw them worshipping idols, He asked them, a'ifkan alihatan duna Allahi turidun, are these false deities that you desire, you want, rather than wanting to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Then He asked them a question that inshallah ta'ala our khutbah revolves around this question that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, or in this verse, Ibrahim alayhi wa ala nabiyyina afdalu salati wa taslim, He asks, فَمَا ظَنُّكُمْ بِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ, what are your thoughts about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of the worlds? That if you had husn dhann, these are a people who are worshipping idols, and yet they believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to forgive them. Just like me and you, وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ, we are predisposed, of course, to commit sins. It is in our nature. But despite the fact that we, you know, we fall into sins, we are supposed to hurriedly seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But when we tarry, when we delay to seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then we have a delusion that we are going to be forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَمَا ظَنُّكُمْ بِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ, what are our thoughts about the Lord of the worlds who has created us, and He has promised righteous people who engage in righteous deeds, He has promised them Jannah, as well as He has warned those who are rebellious, who rebel against, you know, the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with an-nar. What are our thoughts? That do we expect that when we commit sins, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is just going to simply forgive us without engaging in a tawbah, in righteousness? So, فَمَا ظَنُّكُمْ بِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. This is why we need to have husnul dhan. And the hadith of Jabir radiallahu anhu, where he says, لا يموتن أحدكم إلا وهو حسن الظن بالله عز وجل. None of you should die except having good thoughts of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, assuming the best of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that I am about to die, I have done what I have done. At that point, you're supposed to تغلبوا جانب الرجاء, that you have more hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted my amal as-salih, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted my tawbah. And at that point, you're supposed to have that ar-raja, you have that hope. Otherwise, if you do not have hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you do not have husn al-dhan with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what is going to happen? Just like similar to, you know, the pessimist. If it is said, and science tells us, when you're a pessimist, you want to embark on something, you already believe that failure is inevitable. You already believe that failure is inevitable. And therefore, what will happen is that you will start believing that you have, or you have already failed. And what will this do to you? It will make you not take the necessary steps because you feel there is no point. There is no point. When you believe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to accept, when you believe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to forgive me, then this gives you that motivation and that push, inshallah ta'ala, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and keep away from things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prohibited. Otherwise, the attribute of the munafiqeen and the mushrikeen who have haba, evil thoughts of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, these are the people who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Al-dhanina billahi dhanna saw," because they have evil thoughts of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they continue engaging in sins, and it's as if they have already despaired. And this is why we find the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam kana yu'jibuhu, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to love, you know, al-fa'alul hasan. And more important, something that unfortunately, as Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala also says, he says, inna kullal khalq. He says, innal khalq, bal kullal khalq. He says, if you look at many people, or if you look at, you know, the creation, but most of them, illa ma shaa Allah, except those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mercy on them. What do you find? And this is the su'ul dhan that some of us have. He says that inna bani Adam, many among the sons of Adam, what thoughts do they have? يَظُنُّونَ أَوْ يَعْتَقِدُونَ أَنَّهُ مَبْخُوسُ الْحَظِّ, مَبْخُوسُ الْحَقِّ, نَاقِسُ الْحَظِّ. Many people, this is how they relate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is how they believe of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَنَّهُ مَبْخُوسُ الْحَقِّ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has been unfair to them. You look at yourself and you say, why am I in this situation? I should have had this, or I should have had that. I should have had a bigger house, or this or that. So he says, mabhusul haq, naqisul hadh, that, you know, he is in a state that he is not deserving, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has deprived him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has denied things that he deserves. وَلِسَانُ حَالِهِ, and what he is communicating is what? يَقُول لِسَانُ حَالِهِ ظَلَمَنِي رَبِّي, my Lord has been unfair to me. ظَلَمَنِي رَبِّي وَمَنَعَنِي مِمَّا أَسْتَحِقْ. Subhanallah. He says that وَلِسَانُ حَالِهِ, we express the way we think, the way we think about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we look at our lives and we think, ظَلَمَنِي رَبِّي وَإِنَّهُ لَا يَتَجَاسَرُ, One would not verbally say this, but we all believe in this, that, you know, my Lord has been unfair to me. He has denied me things that I deserve. Subhanallah. And this is part of su'ul dhann billah, that you believe that you deserve more or better than what you have. فَمَا ظَنُّكُمْ بِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. So this is not only found among the munafiqeen and the mushrikeen, but even believers, we tend to harbor this thought that my Lord has been unfair to me. He has denied me what I deserve or what I should have had, or I deserve more than this. Subhanallah. And therefore, what happens is like a woman was worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and when she saw somebody who is rebellious, who does not worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is a sinner, he is a kafir, and she says, I've been worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all this time. Why is he denying me this? Why is he not giving me this? And then you stop worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is as if you believe you are doing a favor to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا بِكُم مِّن نِعْمَةٍ. All the favors, all the bounties that we enjoy, all of them are from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the lives that we live, whatever we have, either it is from the fadl, the gratitude of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the magnanimity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or al-adl, that his fairness, and that is why we have whatever we have. Otherwise, when you start feeling, or when you start having ill thoughts of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it will make you think that you deserve more, and it will make you start thinking that maybe I am worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is as if you are repaying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the things that you have. The Sahabas, they used to be so keen on this subject that Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu says, مَا أُعْطِيَ عَبْدٌ مُؤْمِنٌ شَيْئًا خَيْرًا مِنْ حُسْنِ الظَّنِّ بِاللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. A servant, a believing servant, has not been given anything better than having good thoughts of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because when you have good thoughts of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you with whatever you desire. Because everything that you desire is milk of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is among the possessions of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم وهو البر الكريم. الحمد لله، الحمد لله على إحسانه والشكر له على توفيقه وامتنانه، والصلاة والسلام الأتمان الأكملان على الرحمة المهداة محمد بن عبد الله معلم البشرية وهاديها إلى سبيل الرشاد، وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. Brothers in Islam, there is another aspect of husnul dhan that is also lost to many of us, and this world revolves around the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is of two types: iradatullahi الكونية وإرادة الله الشرعية. What does this mean? إرادة الله الكونية is the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala based on his knowledge. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created this world, he has created everything that is on this earth, and he has put a predisposition, meaning that the nature of this world is that there will always be al-khayr wa-shar. This is the nature of this world. And these are what we would refer to as the natural laws. The natural laws. Such that, man jadda wajad. There is a saying in Arabic that says, man jadda wajad. that if you strive, you put effort, then inshallah ta'ala you will succeed. And these natural laws do not depend on iman. They are not dependent on iman. It does not depend on if you are a believer and you put effort, then you will succeed. You are a disbeliever, you put effort, you're not going to succeed. No. The natural laws, they do not depend on al-iman wal-kufr. This is the nature of this world. So people, you know, strive, they strategize, and they succeed. Whether that succession is min mardatillah, something that is pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if somebody was to scheme and plot and steal and do whatever, you know, he desires or he has planned to do, he might succeed. This is part of the natural laws. And this is what we call the iradatullah al-kawniyah. This iradatullah al-kawniyah, we would say as human beings, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted this to happen. But it only means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knew it was going to happen. He created the environment for it to happen. This is the nature of this world. However, there is iradatullah al-shar'iyyah, the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He loves. Yuridullahu bikumul yusr. So between these two iradat, between these two wills of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sometimes there is confusion. So that you confuse something has happened and you attribute it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala negatively. Meaning you say this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted. Would you say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted you to kill and, you know, smoke and commit zina and what have you? No, you would not say that. Although at the back of our minds we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created al-khayr wa shar. And this is why we would say iradatullah. This is the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when something happens and it falls into the iradatullah al-kawniyah, this is the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created this world. There is khair and there is shar. We need to exercise patience. We need not, you know, feel that we are triumphant. We have succeeded. Well, we have succeeded to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What we should be working towards is iradatullah al-shar'iyyah. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us al-ibadah. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to worship Him, and anything that revolves around worship, this is iradatullah al-shar'iyyah. And this is what we should be working towards, inshallah ta'ala. Otherwise, when something among the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would say, this is part of the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, happens, and it is among the iradatullah al-kawniyyah, then we exercise patience, we seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from our shortcomings. But it should never be a point where we feel that we have done well. Would you ever see someone, you know, he has committed a sin and he is happy and then attributing that to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? As the Arabs say, ahashafan wasu akila. This man that came to, was brought to Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu, and he had drunk. He was intoxicated. He had been drinking alcohol. And then when he was brought to Umar radiallahu anhu, he says, you know, this, Allah prescribed this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, in al-Qadr, He had already prescribed that I'm going to drink. What did Umar radiallahu anhu tell him? He told him, if Allah prescribed for you to drink, He has prescribed for us to flog you. Simple. Because he's using al-Qadr in the wrong way. He's using al-Qadr in the wrong way. So basically what I am saying here, inshallah ta'ala, and reminding myself and each one of us, is that there is iradatullah al-kawniyah and there is iradatullah shar'iyyah. We are supposed to exercise patience and accept the qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on one side, while we are supposed to work towards pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and not mix the two, and we should always differentiate between the two. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu says, or rather he used to supplicate, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allahumma inni as'aluka sidqa at-tawakkul. Ya Allah, I ask of you sincerity in depending on putting my trust to you. Wa husna dhanni bika. And this is our supplication, insha'Allah ta'ala. Nas'alu Allah al-Azima, Rabb al-Arsh al-Kareem, sidqa at-tawakkuli alayk wa husna dhanni bika. Ala fasallu wa sallimu ala khayril bashir. Faqad amarakum al-bari bithalika haythu qal, إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. وارض اللهم عن الخلفاء الراشدين أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن سائر الصحابة أجمعين وعنا معهم بجودك وكرمك يا أكرم الأكرمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين واحمي حوزة الإسلام يا رب العالمين. اللهم عليك باليهود ومن هاودهم والنصارى ومن ناصرهم والشيوعية ومن شايعهم والمنافقين ومن وافقهم. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم، ولذكر الله أكبر وأولى وأتم. أقم الصلاة.